omnia in saecula misericordia eis. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Amen.
trusti me et coniovisti me. Tu coniovisti sessionem meam et resurrectionem meam. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto. Sicut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Resurrexi, et adut tecum Kyrie.
Die per unigenitum tuum eternitatis nobis ad eum de victa morte reservasti vota nostra quae preveniendo aspiras et siam adiuvando prosequere per eundem dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum qui te cum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Lectio Epistulae Beati Pauli Apostoli ad Corinthios. Fratres, est purgate petrus fermentus, ut est in nova conspersio sicus testis acimi. Et enim pasca nostrum immolatus est Christus. Et atque ebulentus, non in fermento pederi, neque in fermento malitiae, sed in acimi sinceritatis et veritatis.
Domino
Ciente spiderunt per voluntum lapidem. erat qui te manius valede, et in proiuntes in monumentum viderunt juvenem sedentem in dextris, opertum stola candida et obstu puerunt. Qui dixit in his, noli te expareschere, Iesus quaeritis Nazarenum, crucifixum, surrexit, non est hic, ecce locus divi posuerunt meum. Sed ite dicite discipulis eius et Petro, quia precedit vos in Galileam, ibi eum videbitis, sic ut dixit homo.
Desire to be first, my dear faithful. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, amen. At first thought, we may be unwilling to admit any desire to be first, as it could be a sign of a lack of humility. And it is, of course, unreasonable to insist on being first in all things. For not only is it impossible, but this sort of tendency can show an excessive pride or self-love. Nonetheless, there are some things in which we should desire to be first. From the Gospel chosen for the morning Mass of Easter Sunday, we read Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James and Salome, brought sweet spices that coming might anoint Jesus. And very early in the morning, the first day of the week, they come to the sepulchre. They wanted to be first to honor the remains of our Lord. And the Gospel of St. John relates that this same morning, the women, seeing that the tomb was opened, came to Simon Peter to tell them of what they had seen. The Gospel then relates, Peter therefore went out and the other disciple, and they came to the sepulchre. And they both ran together, and that the other disciple did outrun Peter and came first to the sepulchre. This is from John chapter 20. And this other disciple was St. John himself. Such was his love for the Lord, he wanted to be first to see whether the body of his Lord was indeed there or not. So on this Easter morning, let us ask ourselves whether we desire to be first to adore Christ. Do we desire to be the first that seek him, the first to worship him? And then, do our actions show that he is indeed of first or of primary importance in our life? Many of us are pining now to return to Holy Mass and the sacraments without delay. Well, do we desire this because we want to be first to give homage to our God always and everywhere? Or simply because something we took for granted for such a long time is now no longer available? The love of Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James and Salome, was so great that they did not waste any time setting out to properly care for the body of the Lord, which had been so violently abused a short time before. They did not wait until the end of the day, waiting until they had visited with one another, waited until they had finished their errands, not even before they had talked to St. Peter. They went at first light. The honor and glory of God was first in their lives. So again, do we imitate their desire to be first when it comes to rendering God that to which he has a right? We can ask ourselves, for example, do we pray at first light? Do we seek our Lord at first light? Before we begin our day, preparing for work, preparing for school, do we kneel down and greet our Lord with at least a short prayer of thanksgiving and an offering to him for the day? Do we want to be first? In reality, we'll find that many times a plethora of other concerns come first, the result of which is that we may forget to pray at all to our Lord during the whole day. And then we would have the gall to get upset when Christ does not come immediately to us when we cry out to him in whatever distress is currently assailing us. Furthermore, when we go to Holy Mass, do we want to be first? Do we pine after the Lord in the Blessed Sacrament so much that we desire to have a front row seat? Old videos that were taken during the life of St. Padre Pio show crowds of people rushing into his masses, crushing. It's not just a few people. There are many. They're rushing in to be first and to have the first seats. The spectacle almost inspires laughter. Who, after all, would run into a mass like that? And were these pilgrims wrong to do this? I don't think so, but that's another subject for another time. But we must ask, did they, or do we, have the love of Christ such that we desire to be the first into church for Mass and to be the first attendants to our Lord? A king, a president, or a governor insists on having his closest advisors, confidants, and friends right near them. They are not all the way in the back of the room. They are usually up close to his desk or up close to the throne, whatever the case may be, so that they may be consulted at any moment's notice, or bare minimum, because the ruler enjoys their company in particular. Is our friendship with the Lord such that we desire to be first, immediately in his view? Do we desire to be close to his throne? Do we run to him as St. John ran to his sepulcher on that first Easter morning so many years ago? The sacrifice that we just commemorated on Good Friday, does it not evidence a burning love from our Lord that should inspire a desire in us to be first to serve him, to be nearest to him as well? Similarly, when we manage our lives while on this earth, do we want to be the first to offer up that which we do for Christ? Do we run a business that serves our personal interests first, or do we make sure that our enterprise serves Christ first? And the same would go for things like volunteering. Do we help? Do we donate our time to help Christ and his church first, or do we do something entirely related, such that, well, in the end, we don't have any room to do things with the local parish or the local church because I'm doing something else that at the end of the day has little, if any, connection with the honor and glory of God? Now, this does not mean that our businesses, our personal professions, or volunteering obligations solely exist to support the needs of the church. One must take care of his family and his interests that help the preservation of those things. What we must ask ourselves, though, is whether the zeal with which we work to maintain these things that will all leave us when we die is lavished also upon Christ and his church as part of our first considerations. And then, when we distribute our charity, do we give to Christ first, or do we remunerate all others and then give him the leftovers, if there are any? Here again, do we rush to Christ first, or do we leave him aside for another time when it's convenient? St. Paul says, "Know you not that they that run in the race all run indeed, but one receiveth the prize? So run that you may obtain." Run that you may obtain. In other words, be first. Desire to be first in the service of Christ and his church. The ladies who visited the tomb Easter morning, as well as Saints John and Peter, are memorialized in the history of the church because they desire to be first, to be the first to search and serve Christ. And this, not just on Easter morning, but all the days of their life. May it please God that their example be impressed upon our minds and upon our hearts this Easter morning, so that we too will not only desire this primacy of Christ in our lives and society, but that we will do concrete actions in our lives to make it something that's actually lived. Omnia pro Christo, all for Christ. May this be our motto. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, amen.
Emui et cui
et omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum.
Ecum spiritu tuo.
Tuus me corda.
Abemus ad Domino.
Gratias agamus, Domino Deo nostro.
Digno et justo est.
Redignum et justum est, ecum et salutam. Equirem Domine omni tempore, sed in ad potissimum die gloriosus predicare. Cum Pascha nostrum immolatus est Christus. Im senil verus est annus, qui abstulit peccata mundi. Qui mortem nostra moriendo destruxit, et vitam resurgendo reparavit. Et ideo, cum angelis et arcangelis, cum tronis et dominationibus, cumque omni militia celestis exercitus, imnum gloriae tue canimus, sine fine dicentes.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Abbao, lenis sunt celi et terra, Hosanna in excelsis.
Omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
O Venus, perceptis salutaribus moniti, et divina institutione formati, audemus dicere, Pater noster, qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostrum, et ne nos inducas in tentationem.
Sed libera nos a malo.
Per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Pax Domini sit semper vobis.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Agnus Dei,
qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere.
Speak on.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pace.
Domine.
Confiteor de omnipotenti, Beate Mariae Semper Virgini, Beato Michaeli Arcangelo, Beato Ioanni Baptiste, Sanctis Apostolis Petro et Paolo, omnibus sanctis et vivi pater, qui efficavi nimis cogitatione verbo et opere, mea culpa, mea culpa, mea maxima culpa. Idioque cor Beata Mariam Semper Virginem, Beatum Michaelem Arcangelum, Beatum Ioannem Baptistam, Sanctus Apostolos Petrum et Paulum, Omnes Sanctos et me Pater. Orare pro me et Dominum Deum nostrum.
Miserat ovis qui omnipotens Deus, et dimissis peccatis estris, perducat vos ad vitam aeternam. Indulgentiam absolutionem et remissionem peccatorum ves vorum, tribuat vobis omnipotens et misericors Dominus.
Amen.
Ecce nisi, ecce quitulit peccata mundi.
Domine non subinus in res rectum meum, sed unto dic verbo servitorum. Domine non subinus in res rectum meum, sed unto dic verbo servitorum. Domine non subinus in res rectum meum, sed unto dic verbo servitorum.
Pascha nostru.
Spiritum nobis Domine tue caritatis in funde, ut quos sacramentis pascalibus satiasti. tu facias pietà de concordes. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui te cum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobis,
et cum spiritu tuo.
Omnipotens Deus,
Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus.